Welcome to another Bumpy video, and my name is Art. I haven't done any car spotting in the streets for a very long time, and I actually wasn't planning to do that either, but then something made me change my mind. But first, let's do a proper introduction to this video. My summer vacation was mainly in Hungary, and in my experience, the Hungarian automotive scene seems to be revolving around BMW, Audi and Volkswagen, where the average mod can be called German, typically German. I have spotted some Japanese cars in the past, but most of them got the same German treatment. I did spot some JDM cars, where JDM actually means it's inspired by the cars from the Japanese soil, but these were actually very rare occasions. But this is enough sidetracking, and let's return to this summer. So first of all, what did I spot that didn't get photographed by me? Well, many Hondas, for instance. The area where our summer cottage is located is apparently a Honda savvy location. I also spotted an Evo 9 and a heavily tuned CRX Del Sol at the exact same spot on two different occasions. Somewhere in a small village along the M8, I spotted an RX8 parked in a small side road, and well, basically that's about it what's interesting. So what made me change my mind to make this video? Well, you already spotted that briefly in the introduction. A Suzuki Carry truck that has been parked in a field in the same village as our summer cottage. The Carry has been sold worldwide, and Hungary is a Suzuki-minded country, so I thought no big deal. Throughout the years, I passed it multiple times and never gave it any thought, until one day during this vacation, I had to slow down and stop for the local bus. And that's when I noticed that it actually was a right-hand drive model. So I stopped and walked up to the little truck. Once I got nearby, I noticed a few things. Firstly, the truck features 660 badging, meaning it falls into the K-Class with a 660cc engine. Secondly, it features a diff lock badge and a four-wheel drive badge that is hidden behind the 25 km/h sticker. Here is a photograph of another Suzuki Carry with that sticker, showing the four-wheel drive sticker as a reference. The taillights and the headlights surrounding put this Carry into the 1989 till 1991-1992 bracket. And lastly, the license plate is a fake fantasy plate, and it's definitely not a Hungarian issued plate. Maybe the owner is called Gabi or Gabor, or maybe his dog, I don't know. There was nobody around, so I couldn't ask. Hungarian farm vehicles like tractors that drive on public roads also have to feature license plates, but I'm not sure about smaller vehicles limited to 25 km/h. So it could be the case that these are exempted. Anyway, my conclusion was that this Suzuki Carry is most definitely a four-wheel drive model from the Japanese domestic market and is or was used as a farm vehicle. As it's relatively clean, there's no overgrowth to be found, it actually must be in regular use. So my big question is, who would actually import a Suzuki Carry all the way from Japan to Hungary for this purpose? After spotting the Carry, I decided to make photos of any interesting car that I would spot. Unfortunately, I spotted the Carry on the last day before I left, so there was only one more car to be spotted just before the Austrian border. This Fiat 500, built in license by the Austrian company Steyr Puch. In Salzburg, I found this blue 2013 Honda Civic parked two blocks away from our hotel. And for those unaware, I own the exact same car. And I actually was driving the exact same car throughout our vacation. So the two of them could have been next to each other on the Honda assembly line in the UK. The very next day, it actually was gone, so unfortunately there was no chance of making a side-by-side shot. Inside the Salzburg Altstadt, I spotted this post-1959 Skoda Felicia Cabriolet parked next to the curb. It features Salzburg license plate, so probably it's a local. Next up, we moved to Innsbruck to travel with the overnight express to Düsseldorf. When we arrived, we were welcomed by a nice lineup of classic cars. The people on the train could be actually divided into two groups: car enthusiasts enjoying the Alps and families not willing to drive more than a few hours with their screaming kids in the rear seat. And to be honest, I fall into the latter category. All modern family commuters were placed on the upper deck, and all sports cars and bikes on the lower deck. But for some bizarre reason, my Honda Civic was directed to the lower. This also allowed me to shoot this nice video of the lower deck the very next morning when we arrived in Düsseldorf. As you can see, these awesome cars were a nicely modded Mini from Belgium, a Dutch Mercedes 190 SL from the 1960s, a Belgian Rolls-Royce Corniche Cabriolet, and then my Honda Civic wedged between the Corniche and a new 4th generation Belgian Mazda MX-5, and finally a Lotus Elise. This obviously was the end of our journey and no more cars were to be spotted. So that's it for now. If you made it this far, let me know what your thoughts are on the Suzuki Carry. And thank you for watching and I hope to see you soon. Pam Tekun RX.